Now, an ECN starts out with essentially one large bank. This large bank will only place larger trades in the market, generally speaking. However, what they could also do is make a deal with a business or with a firm, something like GFT, but not GFT. This ECN, essentially collects traders. You get a series of smaller traders that are all built within this circle of the ECN. Now, within this ECN, it essentially becomes its own market. Each of these traders trade with one another. The bank creates and provides liquidity and prices for these traders to trade with one another. However, in an ECN environment, you have inherent risks in that you have a very limited amount of traders that are actually trading in that network. Now, if you have a limited amount of traders, you're actually cut off from the rest of the market. If you're cut off from the rest of the market, then you are seriously hindering the ability you have in order to be able to take advantage of the full liquidity of this market. Like I said, there's $4 trillion traded daily in this market. If you trade within an ECN, you are seriously hindering that liquidity and not giving yourself the ability to take advantage of the full breadth of this market. Now, ECN might be a great idea, trade with other traders out there, but remember, whenever you place a trade, somebody else has to take the other side of that transaction. So if you place a buy order, somebody else has to sell to you. So therefore, there's always somebody else on the other end of that transaction.